to a Jordanian friend yesterday, and he was saying that in his region, the first question that people ask is, "What's your name?" And then, "What does the name mean?" And I said, "Well, that's interesting, because in our catechism, the first question you get asked is, what is your name? And the second question is, who gave you that name?" Names are so important. So I was thinking that it's also rather important that the names that we give to the books of the Bible. And I'm reading through what Christians call the book of Exodus at the moment, and I'm reading it in a Jewish translation where it's not called Exodus but Shemos, the names. Now, every weekly portion of the Torah is given a name, and on one level, the name is just one of the words that's used early on in the passage. But it's quite interesting to think about it. The first part of Exodus begins, "These are the names." And that's why Shemos is the name that is given to that passage, as well as to the whole book. Do we call it Exodus, marking the great event of the going out from Egypt, the redemption? Certainly, from a New Testament perspective, that's at the heart of what we learn about God, and the whole question of redemption is at the heart of the Christian view of sacred history. That's what it's about. It's about our redemption. And yet, this book of Exodus starts, "And these are the names." The rabbis point out the importance of that "and." This book doesn't start from nothing, it's a continuation from Genesis, which tells us about the family of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. And these are the names. This book is not just about an event, it's about people, the people to which that event happened. And we can read it looking at those people and their families, and how God worked in them and through them. It's very interesting, though, that the names are only the names of the leaders of the 12 tribes, the 12 brothers that we get there, and then we're told that there are 70 of them that went. And it's not until chapter 6, which is in the next weekly portion of the Torah, that we read of the genealogy of Moses and Aaron. Why is that? Well, the rabbinic comment is that this genealogy is signaling a new stage in redemption. Here's the commentary. In a sense, the mission of redemption begins only now, and it speaks about how God is now going to show his power over Pharaoh, and he is going to set off the movement which is going to redeem the children of Israel from Egypt. Here's what it says. This new stage of the redemption identifies God's agents by tracing their descent from the patriarchs, starting from Jacob's eldest son and progressing to the tribe of Levi, which produces Moses and Aaron. The very fact that their genealogy was not traced until now indicates, that the process of liberation, the background of which has been presented in the last 5.5 chapters, begins only now. Well, if you've read the Gospels, I'm sure you are now thinking, how interesting. Matthew begins his account of the process of redemption with what? A genealogy that is going to take you back to the patriarchs. Luke, a bit like Exodus, starts out with the infancy narratives, and only as Jesus is about to start his public ministry does it give you his genealogy. So, I hope you find that interesting, thinking about names. What is your name, and how do you and your family fit into God's amazing history of redemption?